All right, number one, the radicand is the same. So since the inside is the same, you can go ahead and combine the outside. Well, here you have more pluses. One more, so it's going to be 1 square root of 7, which is just simply the square root of 7. It's understood that there's a 1 right here. Any questions about what I said or what I did? Okay, next. This one is not the same, but maybe you can get something out of here. 3 times 9. 9 is a perfect square, so the square root of 9 is 3. So take a 3 out, but you already have a 3 out. So 3 times 3 is going to give you 9. The 3, this one, has to stay in the inside. If you have 2 3's, you take 1 out. See, that 9 is 2 3's. And if you have 2 3's, or 2 of anything, you take 1 out. The square root of 9 is 3. Any questions about what I did or what I said? Is everybody clear on that? All right. Here you have more pluses. You have 7 more. So your final answer on the per test would be 7 square root of 3. It's not hard. And then you can use your calculator. Right now, I want you to use your calculator to see if you can find out what that really is. It means nothing to me, but I want to see what it is. All right, maybe. Press 3 if you don't know how. Hit shift, hit square root, and then times. Make sure you multiply. Times 7. Yep, 12.124. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? All right. Next. On the next one, they're not the same. See this right here? Look, 6 is 2 and 3, but I don't have 2 2's, and I don't have 2 3's. I can't do anything with it. That's going to stay the square root of 6. This one right here, I know there's a 9. 6 times 9. 9 is a perfect square, so I pull a 3 out, so I get 3 times 3, so I get 2 square root of 6 plus 9 square root of 6 equals 9, 10, 11, 11 square root of 6. Any questions on how to do number 3? It wasn't the same, but I was able to get something out of there to make it the same. Okay, so when you take the per test, they may not look like they're the same, but maybe you can get something out of there to make them the same. Yes? All right, you see the 3 right here was already on the outside, correct? And 6 times 9 is 54, correct? Okay, what's the square root of 9?
Because the 6 was left.
Yep, the 6 is left. I don't have 2 6's or I'd take 1 out. I only have 1 6. And if I break up 6, it's only 2 and 3. You need 2 of a kind in order to take 1 out, which is the nature of the square root. All right, number 4 is what we're doing today. We're going to be multiplying. Now watch how I do this. I'm going to put all of this inside one single radicand. So I'm going to have 3 times 51 and then x times x to the third. Write that down. I'm going to put everything inside one radical. Write this down, sir. I don't think you have this. You have this exactly like this, because I'm going to come over there and check. I want it exactly like this, sir. All right, now watch. I know that maybe 51 seems like it's prime, but I don't think so. So take 51 divided by 3. It's 17. So put 3 times 17 like this. And then x, 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 x. Just copy that down and I'll explain what I did. All right, look here. This was 51. All I did was rewrote it. This was my 3 x's, and this was my 1 x. Is everybody clear? All I'm doing is just making it bigger. Now I need 2 of a kind. Here I have 2 3's, so circle them and take 1 out. We're looking for 2 of a kind. Thank you. Yeah, Brandon's not here.
Thank you.
Yeah. This one right here, I have 2 X's. Circle it, take one out. Here I have two X's. Circle it, take one out. Now on the outside I have a 3. X times X is X squared, and I'm left with 17 on the inside. And that is the answer that I want on today's work. You have to break it down and look for two of a kind. If you have two, take it out. If you have two, take it out. That's all it is. All right, now put away your bell work and try this one. Break it up, and if you have two, take it out. Do I need to send you to another room, sir?
No.
It's your choice. If you don't want to be in here, I'll send you out.
No.
But if you're going to stay in, you got to watch and you got to pay attention.
I'm not asking for you to reply back other than yes or no. All right, break it up just like I did a moment ago. And you look at the two of a kind. You have a calculator, so use your calculator. Alyssa, you don't have your glasses today? Okay, I saw them one day. What happened to them?
Did I see them like this, Jack?
Break up that 45. Break up those A's, break up that 20, and put them all underneath one radical sign. We'll call it an umbrella. Put it all underneath the umbrella. And then look for two of a kind. If you have two, take it out. It's really not that hard, okay? If you have two, take it out. If it's a perfect square, take it out. Break it all the way up. When you're multiplying, you don't need the same writing. It's a different concept. I'll give you one more minute to try to break it up and try to do what you can do. If you can't do it, don't sweat it. I mean, this is the first one I showed you. All right, watch. I know this one is going to be 5 times 9. And I can stop because I know 9 is a perfect square. I know that. This one is going to be 7 of these A's. 7 of them. This one's going to be 4 times 5. And I know 4 is a perfect square. And 1 A. Any questions about what I did so far? This is what you're going to be doing today. All right, watch. The square root of 9 is 3. Take a 3 out. Here I have 2 A's. Take one out. 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 And the square root of 4 is 2. I think I took out everything I could take out. So here we go. 2 times that 3 is going to be 6. A, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 A's. In the inside, I missed this. In the inside, I have 2 5s, but I didn't see it. 5 times 5 is 25. So I can take that out as well. It looks like everything's going to come out of this one. What's the square root of 25? So you're going to do 5 times 6 is 30. So on your test, your PERT test, that's your answer. Any questions about what I said or what I did? I missed it the first time, but later on I saw I had 2 5s. If you have 2 of a kind, you take one out. That's the idea of a square root.
If it was a cubed root, you would need three of them. If it was written like this, that would be the cubed root, which is 8. That would be 2 times 2 times 2 equals 8. And there you got 3, so that's 2. We're not doing the cubed root. We're doing the square root. The square root requires 2 of a kind, not 3 of a kind. So don't worry about that until next year or whatever, algebra 2. All right, I have a worksheet here. I want you to try one. See if you can handle number 8 on this worksheet. Copy it down and do it the same way. Break it all the way down. And see if you can work it. Break it all the way down. When you see a perfect one, you can stop. One more minute. Bless you. Well, you have to try. You know you saw this on the EOC, and it's going to be on the per test. And I don't want you sitting there saying, well, he did try to teach this to me, but I didn't really get it. No, that's not good enough. I want you to say, yeah, he did teach it to me. I think I can do it. All right, here we go. Well, that 18, I know I can do 2 times done. So put one umbrella or one radical like this. So put one radical and then go ahead and break this up as 2 times 9. 9 is perfect. A. The 4 is on the outside. So let me put the 4 out here. And then 3 and then A. So everybody with me so far? All right, well, the square root of 9 is 3, so put a 3 out here, so that's going to give me 12. Here's 2 A's, so take one out right here. Here's 2 more A's, so take another one out. That makes 2 of them on the outside. On the inside, it looks like it's just going to be a 6, and then I'm done. Any questions about what I did? 12A squared, square root of 6. All right, last one, and then I'm going to give you your work. I don't want to use up all your class time. Try to work number 14. You have to distribute. See if you can do it. Draw your arrows and try to distribute that radical. Remember, you got to multiply outside, outside, inside, inside. That was the rule. You multiply the numbers on the outside separate, and then you multiply the numbers on the inside separate. Say it to yourself while I say it. Outside, outside, inside, inside. There's a 1 on the outside. So if you want to put a 1, some kids do. Multiply outside, outside, inside, inside. Try and do it. You have to reach a little bit. Outside, outside, inside, inside. Yesterday, you guys asked some good questions. You started to come around a little bit. May not be too late. All right, watch. What's 1 times negative 5? Negative 5. What's 3 times 10? Good. Now, a positive times a positive is still a positive. 1 times 1 is still 1. And 3 times 6 is 18. Now, 18 is 2 times 9. I know that 9 is a perfect square. So the square root of 9 is 3, and 3 times 1 is going to be 3. So this is 3 square root of 2, this back piece is. This one right here, I don't think anything's going to work. 2 times 15 and 3 times 5, but I don't have 2 of a kind. So since I don't have 2 of 5s or two of these or 2 of those, you got to leave that alone. So your answer on your ELC will be that. Now, if I had to, I'm going to get my calculator out and make sure I got the right answer. Does everybody understand what I'm saying? Okay, because if they give me all day, I'm going to get this one right, even if I got to pull out my calculator. All right. All right. This is FOIL, and I don't want to go into too much. You can try it, okay? I'm not going to show it to you right now, but you should know how to do FOIL. First, outer, inner, last. Okay.
I expect the first side to be completed. And then go on to the second side. Put your name on the top. I got the answers for this worksheet. So all you got to say is, can you show me the answer? Now, if I walk around tomorrow, like some of you did on that PERT test, and you just circle the letter,
oh, I did it.
And there's no work, I'm not going to give it to you now. I might have been born on a Monday, but it wasn't yesterday. Remember, when you multiply outside, outside, inside, inside, and then you got to look for 2 of a kind. If you got 2 of a kind, you got to pull it out. They won't let you do anything else. All right, let me pop the answers up here.
And I want to get back that test, but I want to go over it tomorrow. I don't want to do it today. Let me video this real quick, and then I'll show you. All right, make sure you get the answers that you see up on the screen, okay? So tomorrow, I need to write this down or I'm going to forget. Number one, I want to go over the test. Quadratic equation. Number two, I want to check worksheet. Page one.